good day to you. So, we got some easy music playing today. We have got Celine Dion. It's all coming back to me now. Why do I play this song? Let me tell you why. I got a phone call this morning. I hadn't even rolled out of bed. My bad. I set my alarm for 7:10, okay? I set the alarm 7:10, 7:20, hit snooze a couple times, wake up at 7:30. That's what I shoot for. I like to be in the office by 8:15, okay? Not an early riser. I get a phone call this morning, 7:45, woke me up because I'd hit snooze too many times. That phone call, City of Plano Building Inspector. Well, good morning to you. You just woke me up, good sir. He says, Jason, can I have you in West Plano ASAP to walk through this fence inspection with me? Because due to COVID-19, we're not making customer contact. And I say, well, sir, you just called me. It's not even 8 o'clock in the morning. Can we reschedule this for tomorrow? That way I have a fair heads up and I can be there. He says to me, we can cancel today's appointment. And we can do between 8 and 10 a.m. tomorrow. And I said, sir, that's a 2-hour window. I've completed this job. I have no reason to be on this job site other than to wrap up this inspection. Can we get a better window? Or can I have your contact information, phone number, or email? And I can notify you when I'm on the job. And I could wait a given period at that time. And he says, I could just go to the job. Hold on. Pause. Think about it. Ready? I can just go to the job right now, fill the job, and then you'll have to contact me again to schedule it, and we'll just get it figured out. I just woke up. It took me a moment. Did you just say you threatened me? You're going to go fail my job. I said, what? I said, let's cancel the work order today. Let's just cancel the work order today and let me reschedule this inspection. I said, cancel the work order. He hung up on me. I call my customer. I say, sir, the building inspector is on his way to your property. I would like to contact the building inspection manager before we proceed with this inspection because I've just been threatened that the inspection will fail. I was told that he will fail the inspection. I asked my customer, do not answer the door. The customer wasn't home. When the inspector got to the job, his dad answered the door. His dad let him do the inspection. He gigged me hard. There was 5 things on the list that he failed. Now, yes, there were some certain situations with this fence where we did fail the inspection. This was a fair fail. But if you've contacted me and you've told me that you're going to fail me, then how does that look? How does it look when you threaten me? The reason we're listening to Celine Dion, it's all coming back to me now, is because didn't we just cover this a couple weeks ago? This guy needs to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I should have sent this video along with my email to his manager because I did email his manager. I emailed his direct manager and the directing supervisor over building inspections. And I notified them of exactly what was said to me and the threats that were made to me. Now, I told the inspector on the phone before he hung up on me. I said, sir, you're making aggressive, threatening words towards me in regards to this inspection. You threatened to fail me before you've even gone on site. That is aggression. That is a sign of aggression. That's not being assertive. Now, he hung up on me before I even had a chance to go ahead and preach to him in the matter. Because I would have set up out of bed and I would have gave this guy 15, 20 minutes of my time. And I would have told him how to communicate with me. How do I know this? How do I know this was aggression? You don't think I've used these same words and phrases? And you don't think I know what a trigger word is? Okay, triggers. Granted, he didn't know that I was still laying in bed. Hadn't had my coffee yet. He doesn't know that I'm a slightly cantankerous in the morning. But I is. I wasn't happy. Ruined my day. It ruined my Tuesday. So, I emailed the director and the direct supervisor, and I informed them of what happened. I did not hear from them before I got the inspection from the building permit inspector. He sent me a detailed inspection with the five things that failed. He numbered them 1 through 5, but instead of putting them in order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, he did it in one solid paragraph. So it goes 1, 2, didn't even use periods to separate the twos. It was an absolute wreck. Had no idea how that read, what it was. Some of the things on the permit I never even heard of before. Why? Because they weren't even in the city of Plano fence codes. They're in the city of Plano pool codes. I know now. I will familiarize myself with the pool codes and we'll get this right. I take every opportunity to learn from, and I will most certainly learn from this, and we'll make sure it doesn't happen again. Now, that inspector called me about 2 hours later. I'd had a little bit of time to cool down. I was with the customer on an estimate. I asked that customer, I said, sir, do you mind giving me a moment to handle something? Because this is relatively important. The inspector called me from a private phone number. Therefore, I was not going to be able to return his phone call. I was on the phone with the inspector about 20 minutes. He tore right into just telling me exactly each line item from the inspection. And I gave him that professional courtesy to do so, and he did so. I asked him how to make each and every correction, and we had a professional conversation for about 15 minutes before he finally, in a roundabout way, came out to apologize with the way that he came at me earlier in the day. Now, it wasn't a, I'm sorry I said this, and I'm sorry I said that, and you know what, I'm a big boy. You don't have to do that to me. At least it's an effort. He told me that he had already talked to his supervisors and he knew what the situation was. And I hope that he learned from this situation. I don't expect a guy to get fired. I've been there. I've done that. I worked for the city of Garland customer services for 2 years, and I worked for Garland Animal Services for 5. And I will tell you, there were customers that called in and made complaints about me. Some of them valid, some of them not valid. I do understand sometimes people wake up on the wrong side of the bed. So, that being said, that's where you learn and you grow from those situations. And I hope this gentleman does grow. From the conversation I had from him, he did seem knowledgeable in his industry. He knew what every code was for each and every thing that he failed. He was able to give me the actual code number for that, where I can look it up and research it, and I will do so. So thank you for that, sir. And I hope moving forward, you can communicate with your builders in a more professional manner. Okay. It would have made the whole process go a lot smoother. So, hopefully I can get this gentleman to subscribe to my YouTube channel and maybe watch some of these videos. And in return, I will also work on not being so sensitive in those matters. Those matters, they catch you off guard. And just like I talked about the other day, the difference between reactions and actions. That's one of the reasons I don't like to be thrown off guard, is because I don't like to feel like I'm backed into a corner and I have to react. And this morning I did, at least in my opinion, I feel like it was more of a reaction than an action. Now, I did not cuss this gentleman out. There was a day when I would have done that. I did not do that. And I did try to address it in the most assertive manner possible. Now, what I need to work on is voice inflections. And I know this wasn't face-to-face, but this is something we're going to get to really soon. But there are verbal cues and physical cues with your facial expressions that you make when you communicate with people. And oftentimes I find myself, you see it right there. If I do that and I'm talking to you, what does that make you feel like? That tensions you up, and that says, Jason's mad at me. And that's not necessarily the case. That's just part of my charisma. But I do need to work on that, because a lot of people are not used to that. A lot of people were not raised that way. So, I learned something today, and that's, you can't ask for anything more than that. I learned something today. So, we're going to get this inspection, we're going to get this fence fixed up, and we're going to make it right, because we're going to make it right for the customer. We're going to make it right for the customer. It's for the customer. Because that's what we do. We make customers happy. We provide a service for our customers' fencing needs. That's what we're here for. We're going to get this thing wrapped up. We're going to call the city of Plano back and have this inspector back. And Doesn't look like we'll be shaking hands, does it? Oh, thank goodness I don't have to worry about shaking this dude's hand. COVID-19, thank you, sir.